So the next dish, again. So our next dish is going to be calabacitas a la mexicana. We're going to need onion, some garlic, fresh corn, tomatoes, one serrano chile, some calabacitas chopped in cubes. You can use courgette and some coriander. We are in Oaxaca and the zucchini flowers are in season. We are going to add a lot of them. We are going to make enough calabacitas for about 6 to 8 people. So let's start by prepping our vegetables. I'm going to show you a really good trick for finely chopping an onion. Trim off the bottom and top of your onion. Cut it in half and then slice along the onion lengthways, leaving a tiny gap at the bottom to hold the onion together. Then slice across the onion the opposite way and voila, you have finely diced onion. Crush and finely chop your garlic. We're going to use one serrano chile here, finely chopped. Remove some of the seeds and veins, but you don't need to be too fussy. If you can get a hold of serrano, you can also use jalapeño or even Thai green chiles. Roughly chop a good sized bunch of coriander. You can keep the stems in. We are going to trim all our fresh corn kernels off the cob. You could also use pre-cooked tin or frozen corn if you want. Then we are going to slice our calabacitas into 1.5 cm cubes, trimming off the top and bottom. You can use courgette here. White courgette will work better as it has a slightly sweeter flavor, but any courgette will work. In Spanish, calabacita means little squash. Indigenous people near Oaxaca began cultivating them nearly 10,000 years ago. Together with corn and beans, it is the ancient base of Mexican cuisine. Heat a good sized casserole dish on a medium-high heat and add a good amount of olive oil. Cook up your onions until they are translucent and beginning to get some color. And then add your chopped garlic and chili. Let this cook down a little bit before adding your corn. If you are using pre-cooked corn, you can add it one step later after the courgette. Add a few pinches of salt to help bring out the liquid from the corn. Then add a bit of water just to help bring everything together and add your courgette and tomatoes. Then cook this down for about 15 to 20 minutes to soften and cook everything through. We are going to finish by adding those beautiful courgette flowers, the fresh coriander, and then season to taste with salt and pepper. We had our calabacitas with some fresh made tortillas and a tomatillo salsa to make a taquito, but you could also serve it more like a stew with rice. These calabacitas a la mexicana went down so well with the pork ribs in adobo we made the same day. Check out our videos on how to make the pork ribs and adobo, the salsa and the tortillas. ¡Provecho!